स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम योर सोशल टीचर, MVM स्कूल, यलहंका, न्यूटन. चिल्ड्रन, टुडेज लेसन, दिल्ली सुल्तान. हिस्ट्री सेकेंड लेसन, लेसन ओवरव्यू, इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिल्ली सुल्तान, गुलाम डायनेस्टी, इम्पॉर्टेंट किंग्स कुतुबुद्दीन ऐबक, इल्तमश, रजिया सुल्तान, गियास उद्दीन बलबन. सेकेंड डायनेस्टी, खिलजी डायनेस्टी, मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट किंग अलाउद्दीन खिलजी. तुगलक डायनेस्टी, मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट किंग मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक. सो लास्ट टू डायनेस्टी, सायद डायनेस्टी एंड लोधी डायनेस्टी. चिल्ड्रन, दिल्ली सुल्तान रेफर्स टू द फाइव शॉर्ट लिव्ड मुस्लिम किंगडम. शॉर्ट लिव्ड फाइव मुस्लिम किंगडम. टर्क्स एंड अफगान्स ओरिजिनेटेड the rule the territory of Delhi between 1206 to 1526 century. In the 16th century, the last of their line was overthrown by Mughals. The rule of Turks, which started by Aibak, was continued by the Khilji, Tughlaq, Sayyid and Lodi dynasty till arrival of Mughals. So in the India map, so overall northern regions, all the five dynasties can rule it. So first dynasty, Ghulam dynasty. All the people who succeeded Muhammad Ghori in all the places conquered by him in India were his slaves. Qutbuddin Aibak, who established Turks rule in Delhi, was also a slave. His successors were also slaves. Hence, their ruler is termed as a Ghulam dynasty. Ghulam means slave. Apart from Aibak, many rulers is there. Aibak, Iltamash, Razia Sultan and Balban are the most important kings in Ghulam dynasty. First king, Qutbuddin Aibak. He is a Qutbuddin Aibak. He built Qutb Minar. Qutbuddin Aibak, he was a founder of Ghulam dynasty and gave the strong foundation for the rule of Delhi Sultan. Qutbuddin Aibak belonged to a family of Afghanistan Turk and was sold to a Qazi of Nishapur as a slave by his guardians. Aibak received the education Arabic and Persian language and also trained archery, horse riding and soldiering. Muhammad Ghori who was the governor of Ghazni purchased him as his slave. Aibak attracted the attention of Muhammad Ghori by his bravery. He became the overseas attack on India after the second battle. So first battle of Tarain and second battle of Tarain can between the Prithviraj Chauhan and Muhammad Ghori. So he became the successor of northern India during this period of Muhammad Ghori. He ruled independently after the death of Ghori. Aibak was Qutb ul Islam mosque can construct and also started the building Qutb Minar there itself, and he can give the hostage to many scholars. So next king, Iltamash. Iltamash, he belonged to Ilbari family and also a slave of Qutbuddin Aibak. He was the administrator of Gwalior and became the successor of Aibak. So he was take the position, so all the neighboring countries cannot accepted the Iltamash rule. So he can revolted against him. Iltamash defeated them and then conquered Ranthambore, Mandor, Gwalior, Bailsa, Ajmer, Banaras and many places. At the same time, Mongolians also invaded India for the first time under the leadership of Genghis Khan. Iltamash made them to retreat and finally successfully. Iltamash many achievements. So Caliph Baghdad to issue a letter bestowing administrative power to him. Hiltamash can divide into the kingdom provinces, so he can appoint it as a one provincial officers also, and he can issue the gold, silver coins into the circulation, and he completed the construction of Qutub Minar with Qutubuddin Aibak started, so he was finished built during this time. So this is the contribution of Iltutmish. So next, Queen Razia Sultan. Iltutmish's son Rukubuddin Firoza was incompetent ruler. His daughter Razia Begum became his successor. She was the first woman to ascend throne of Delhi Sultanate. She earned the title of Sultana and participated in battle so a male dress. She established her rule from Sindh to Bengal. The provincial officials who are unable to tolerate her rule revolted and killed her. So Ghiyas-ud-Din Balban, he was also one of the slave of Iltutmish and had been part of Turkish slaves group due to his loyalty, intelligence and good qualities. During the regime, Razia Sultan, he was appointed to post of Amir-e-Shikar. He was supported to Razia Sultan also. He was a politically, he was well knowledgeable. So Balban became the Sultan of Delhi. After becoming the Sultan, Balban controlled the misruled and disobedient Turk Sardars. He destroyed the Turkish Sardar evil group. And once again, Mongolians also can attacked, and he maintained peace and order in this kingdom. He was maintained and implemented many problems and controlled the Mongolians attack also. He wore Persian style dresses. He declared himself as the representative of the god and enforced absolute monarchy. He rebuilt his army with the support of able military generals. In order to repel Mongolians' attack, he built forts along the border of northwestern India. So he was one of the efficient ruler, efficient administrator, and successful by in Delhi Sultanate. So next dynasty, Khilji dynasty. So Jalaluddin Khilji was the founder of this dynasty. Later can occupied Alauddin Khilji. He was Alauddin Khilji was the most famous king of Khilji dynasty. Alauddin Khilji, he grew up under the protection of Jalaluddin during his childhood days. He was a good warrior and served as a governor and also as a military general. He invaded Malwa, Pilwa and Devagiri and plundered a lot of wealth. He was looted. Plundered means looted the wealth. Malwa, Pilwa and Devagiri, other places. He killed his guide and mentor, who is the founder of Khilji dynasty, Jalaluddin. So Alauddin Khilji killed Jalaluddin by treating the path of murder and plunder. Alauddin became the Sultan of Delhi. Alauddin attack of Mongolians, he defeated the Rajput kings Karnadeva II and Waghela dynasty, Hamir Deva of Ranathambore and Bhima Singh of Chittor. Many other kings can invaded. He was successfully can own the war. And the honors of successful competition, Southern India invasion goes to General Mallikaful, can give the in charge. During this time, he invaded Devagiri, Warangal, Dwarasamudra and Madurai and became responsible for their destruction. He did not integrate the conquered state into his state, but simply plundered them. looted all the places. He was looted the wealth. Qutbuddin Mubarak ruled the 4 years and murdered his soldiers Khusru, later Ghazni Malik, Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, murdered Khusru and established the Tughlaq dynasty. So in Alauddin Khilji's administration reformation, Alauddin Khilji implemented various reforms in the administration. He abolished religious endowment, inam, land and subsidy. Efficient intelligence network of established by him. He prohibited alcohol, drugs and dice game. Banned the association formation among his sardars, lieutenants. And many programs also can help and can give the helpful to the especially farmers and big landlords had to pay the taxes. He appointed revenue officials to collect the fixed taxes from the farmers. Next, military reforms. The task of recruiting, training of soldiers. So nowadays can give the police department can give the training as it is. Before Alauddin Khilji can give the trainings, horse, so defense purpose only. The salary of the soldiers dispersed on the last day of the month in the form of cash. The individual record of the soldiers were created based on their physical features. He was the circulation of the coins also can releasing. So next, market reforms. The reforms in the market that were implemented by Alauddin Khilji ensured him a special place in the history. He created a system wherein common people had access to pulses, cereals, cooking oil, sugar, salt, fuel at the fair prices. So common people also can purchase the things. So price also common price. Not high, not low. There is a fixed price, can fix it. He appointed higher officials named Sahan-e-Mandi and regulate the markets. It was the responsibility of the person in market. Severe punishment were according to the cheaters. Anyone person can cheat in a market, so can give severe punishment. So next dynasty, Tughlaq dynasty. Tughlaq dynasty founded by Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. Ghiyasuddin maintained peace and order in Delhi by implementing liberal administrative policies. He conquered Madurai, Warangal and maintained law and order in Gujarat and Bengal. Many other important kings also can rule. Most important king, Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was a scholar of Persian and Arabic language. He was an expert in mathematics, physics, medicine, Persian poetry, astronomy, and other subjects. He was a knowledgeable person and few abnormalities decision in his personality. He was thinking ahead of his time, often centuries ahead. But his official neither had the integrity nor a maturity to implement his plan. Administrative reforms. Revenue reforms. An official record that had all the details to land of the empire was implemented by him. He established a department of agriculture. Uncultivated land and cultivated land can different taxes can fix it. The farmers of Doab had to pay higher land taxes during this time. Shifting of his capital. So this decision only the abnormal decision. Muhammad bin Tughlaq shifted his capital from Delhi to Devagiri in central India. There are two main reasons behind his move. to establish the capital city at the center of the vast empire and to protect the capital city from foreign invasion. This is the main aim. This is the main reasons only can shifting the capital. Though the plan was good, proper precautions were not taken to implement this. As a result, innumerable common people suffered severely. Shifting capital only, but he was shifted with people and all the commodities. That is a problem. So shifted of his capital. So this decision is abnormal decision. Next, administrative reforms, experiment of symbolic coins. This is also, this decision also abnormal decision. The value of the currency was made adjusted of value of gold and silver coins in circulation of his time. He brought gold coin named dinar and silver coin named adli, not circulation. The coins were aesthetically designed. After few years, the copper and brass coin were introduced, circulation for symbolically. Next, the minting coins was not wasted with the government alone. Families and common people also can minted the coins. Traditionally, right to mint coins were also there. The coin were minted more than the required number without the permission of the Sultan. Common people and any rich people also can mint it. The resulted in chose the state treasury became empty due to costly administrative experiments served drought and shifting of the capital city. That is also one problem can creating. Relocating the capital back and other measure once again can shift to Delhi to Devagiri. So next Devagiri to Delhi. So relocating the capital back. This is also, this decision also abnormal. Next, Deccan policy. Muhammad bin Tughlaq implemented his administration and areas conquered by him in Deccan. Areas, Deccan places. So conquered Warangal, Kakatiyas, the capital of Kakatiyas. He also destroyed the Dwarasamudra, the capital of Vaisalas, today's Halebidu. Madurai of the South India was conquered by Jalaluddin Hasan Shah as a named governor. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was the first Delhi Sultan to establish vast empire in India. He was a brave, he was a scholar also. Was well-knowledged person also. So many other persons, so in southern parts also he can occupy Vijayanagara, Hoysala dynasty, Kakatiya, so all the dynasties can occupy. Later Tughlaq, Firoz Shah Tughlaq, who conquered the throne after Muhammad bin Tughlaq, implemented numerous people friendly program. He waived a takawi loans for the benefit of his subject. He paid compensation to the victim of Muhammad bin Tughlaq's invasion to private mines used to be taxed, and also taxes were collected. He built many cities, mosques, madrasas, dams, irrigation facility. Palaces also can constructing, and famous learning center also, and dharmashalas were built for the benefit of to traveler. So before there is no transportation, so only walking only, that's why can construct and build a dharmashalas, chowtries. So next dynasty, Syed dynasty. So this is Syed dynasties that is not participated. Most important king is not there. Khizr Khan Syed, the governor of Multan, founded this dynasty, conquering Delhi. He established his rule Doab, Bian and Gwalior only. So next, Bahlul Lodi defeated Alam Shah and brought the end of the rule. Syed dynasty cannot establish the other kingdoms, not occupied. So that is the end of this dynasty, 1414 to 1451. So the declining. Next, last dynasty, Lodi dynasty. This is the last Sultanate dynasty of Delhi. Bahula Lodi, Sikandar Lodi and Ibrahim Lodi. That is the most important Sultanate of this dynasty. Sikandar Lodi conquered Bihar, Bengal, Dholpur and Chanderi, and he maintained peaceful in Delhi. So next, Ibrahim Lodi, the successor of Sikandar Lodi, was incompetent. Afghans were invited to invade India by the governors Alam Khan and Daulat Khan. So he defeated, Ibrahim Lodi defeated the first battle of Panipat in 1526 century, and he established the Mughal rule in India. So all the Delhi Sultan dynasty can decline it. Children, contribution of Delhi Sultans dropped. So I give the classwork in PDF. Thank you.